What up, y'all? So we're going to talk about search engine optimization, which is something that I'm trying to learn more about. And I'm learning that through the website that I launched, MrPowerScripts.com, which is just a blog that I'm going to be using as sort of a tool to learn all of this stuff. And as I said in my last video, the main tool that I'm using to monitor my success in improving my search engine optimization is this product called Google Search Console. And it's something that's free. Anybody can use it. It's really easy to get it set up on your website. All you have to do is add a Google tag to your page, and then immediately you get these insights into how people are searching your page, how Google is interpreting your page, and whether it's indexed. And so this is a really, really great tool to use. So if we take a look at the performance of my site so far, it's been around for, I guess, more than a month at this point. But you can see over time, I'm starting to get more impressions, which means that more people are finding my blog and my blog post in their Google search results. And we can see that the clicks are increasing in frequency as well, which probably means that my blog posts are getting ranked a bit higher. And so people are seeing them as very early results and they're more inclined to click on those. I think one of my favorite jokes that I've seen on the internet is, where's the best place to hide a dead body? The second page of Google results. Because people typically aren't going to go to the next page. They're going to find the things that they want on the first page and they're not going to dig any deeper. So it's really important to be well optimized so that your site is getting ranked as high as possible from Google, given that they own like 80% of the search market or something like that. Like, nobody cares about Bing. Oh, poor Bing. They tried. Bing it. One of the best ways to get your site on Google and to make sure that things are working well and Google is able to find your pages and it's able to parse your pages and it's able to index your pages, and that is to have a sitemap. And a sitemap is just a document that describes all of the different pages on your website. So in the Google Search Console, you can click on these sitemaps here to the left, and the sitemap must be on your website. It must be available from the domain name. And so you can come in here and you can type in the name of your sitemap, and mine is called sitemap.xml, and then you can submit it, and Google will go and it will try to get it and it will parse it. We can see here that I've had this sitemap submitted and that it was able to discover 12 URLs from the sitemap and that it was successful. It was good. And if we take a look at the sitemap here, this is the live sitemap on my website. And it's not really anything special. It's just an XML document that shares information about the URLs that exist on the site. So you can see they are wrapped in these URL tags. And then there's a location tag, which is the URL itself. And then there's the last modification tag, which tells the last time that the page was updated. And so this gets submitted to Google, and then Google doesn't have to try and figure out what pages are on our website. We give it the list, it goes through the links, and then on its own time, it will crawl the website from the links that we give, and if it likes them, it will index them, and that makes it easier for people to find the pages of our site. So I don't have to create this thing manually. This is always created for me automatically because I'm using GitHub Pages, which is using this Jekyll templating engine. And the templating engine has this sitemap plugin, which automatically figures out all the URLs in my site, and then it creates that sitemap for me. So I don't even have to worry about it. It's automatically created for me. Every time I make a blog post, I'll go in to the Search Console and resubmit my sitemap, and Google will see it, and then eventually at some point in the future, it will find it and it will see if it can index it. And we can actually see that in the coverage report. And this coverage report, you click on it over here, it tells you what Google is doing with your site. And so if we check the valid links here, you'll see that over time, some links have been added and have been validated, and some even lost their validation. And then I added some more and they were validated as well. And so there's kind of a wishy-washy situation in how that all gets done. It's sort of a behind the scenes Google thing, and there's not a whole lot of explanation on when, why, or how some things will be valid and some things will be excluded. But you can go in here and you can get a little bit more information by checking out the excluded items. And sometimes it gives you enough information so that you can figure out what is happening. So for instance, I have a bunch of pages here that are crawled, but they're not currently indexed. And maybe they're in a queue and Google is waiting to index them, but there's really no way to tell. All you can see is what the pages are, and it's up to Google to decide if they want to index it or not. Now, if they are excluded, you can actually go and you can use this tool called URL inspection, or you can click on it from here. And if we open it up, it's gonna grab some data from Google, and we can see, okay, this URL is on Google and it is submitted and indexed. So that's another thing that I've noticed with the Search Console, is that you're not always going to have the most up-to-date information. So you saw that that was a page we were looking at that said it was not indexed. But here, when we click on it and we get the latest information from Google using the URL inspection, apparently it is on Google and it is indexed. But if it's not indexed, you can even come in here and you can say, hey Google, could you please index this? And you can do a request index on it. And that might get it in there a little bit faster. So this is really where I started out, by getting my site onto Google itself, was by submitting the sitemap and then checking out the coverage report to see what was indexed and what is not indexed, and then using the URL inspection tool to check out individual URLs and see, are they actually indexed? Are they not indexed? Should I request indexing? And here you'll also get reports that tell you why or why not it was indexed or it wasn't indexed. And so this is a really great workflow. It's the first one that I followed. Now, telling Google where your pages are is really good, but you want to get your stuff ranked higher. And so the key thing that they always say is to create great, unique content. If you have great, unique content, then when people are searching for that relevant content, you will probably get pushed up higher than other people. But there are some small things that you can do to increase the ranking of your page by informing Google about the type of content on the page. So for instance, let's take a look at this blog post I made called How to Use Git Version Control. I have my video up here. I have the whole post right here, but the important stuff is what's behind the scenes. So let's take a look at the source code and see what I've implemented to help Google understand what is on this page. So if we go here, we'll see this is the source code for my page. It's just basic HTML, but we have something special over here. This is called structured data, and it's not visible to the user unless they're looking at the source code. And this is a machine-readable way of describing the purpose of the page and the content of the page, and that helps search engines understand what the page is about much easier than if it were to try to just look at the content on the page and take a guess. And this stuff is so important to Google. They love this stuff so much that even on their website, they have a guide on how to set up and create this structured data so that it's most accessible for them. So there's a bunch of different formats that you can use to create this structured data. There's the microdata, which is sort of embedding tags within the HTML itself. But the one that they recommend and the one that I like the most is these JSON LD tags. And it's basically taking the structured data and embedding it as JSON in the page. So if we go back to it here, the important thing is the type. So you can see here that this is a blog posting. So immediately, already, when Google parses the page and they see our structured data, they know that the content of this page is a blog post. And that makes it so they can share data more relevantly to their users. They don't have to figure out what this page is about. They know this page is a blog post. And you can provide other information, such as the headline. There's also a description of what the blog post is about. And then since it's a blog post, there's probably going to be an author. So you can supply an author tag. And there could be a publisher. So you can supply a publisher tag. So this stuff is going to help Google understand the content of your page better. And they'll probably rank you a little bit higher if they have more assurance that they're providing a relevant result to their users. So this is really cool. You can see that there's all kinds of content types. Over here to the left, we can see there's a job posting content type, or there's a podcast content type. There's a recipe content type. So if we look at the recipe over here, so you can see Google is explaining right here that by providing this recipe structured data, they can provide more rich content to their users, and then they're gonna rank you higher because you're helping them out. So we can see here, it goes and it describes more information about structured data for this item here. There's structured data about supplying the nutritional calories, the prep time, the recipe category, the recipe cuisine. So Google doesn't have to try and figure that stuff out. They're going to see websites that have this structured data. They're going to want to share those websites more so than they share websites that they can't really figure out and understand. So I don't have to do this manually every single time. The templating engine that I use figures out the content of the page and it automatically generates this structured data for me. All I have to do is write up the blog post and this stuff gets created and I don't have to worry about it. I just create the page, I submit the sitemap, and then Google is going to go through the page. It's going to see that there's structured data. It's going to parse the structured data and it's going to say, that is some good structured data. I really enjoyed consuming your page. Other people are probably going to enjoy it as well. Now, there are some other kinds of tags that you can add to your site that may or may not improve the rankability of it. It really depends on the search engine. But there's this thing called the Open Graph Protocol, which was created by Facebook. So essentially, whenever you share something to a social site, sometimes you'll see that social site create a preview and it will automatically grab a picture, it will grab a title, it will know the URL, it might provide a little summary, and that is usually done through these open graph tags. And these are just meta tags that have a specific property name. And a lot of these search engines and websites and social media sites will understand how to interpret this, and then they will pull that content from the page so that they can create rich cards or rich sharing options for your page. And so it makes your site much more attractive to people that are scrolling by or clicking on things because you can provide a preview image. You can provide your headline, your title, something to get people more interested. So really, you can see I haven't done a whole lot. I'm still figuring things out here, but these are the basic things, and I can see a positive trend happening right now, even though this is super, super small. But I'm gonna come and review this in a month, in 2 months, and we can see how this has improved as I continue to add more content to the site. But search engine optimization is not this crazy monster that you have to try and defeat. There's a lot of resources on the internet. A lot of it can be automated for you, and you just need to understand how to set it up and configure it, and then you are good to go. As always, when I'm sharing something new that I'm learning, I would love feedback. I would love to hear other people's opinions and ideas. That's gonna be it for now. Thanks for watching.